morning to you, ladies and gentlemen, comrades and friends, all put away a present, those who observed. The graceful gentleman before you is Mikhail Daniel Rubin, commonly known as the speaker of nothing but the truth, the orator normally takes everything and leaves nothing but as far as today is concerned. I'm going to be very, very charitable, as one of prize of knowledge and gratitude to all deserving. Now, most of you have the expectations to be honest, which are against gender-based violence, or the scale between education and the girl child, or more importantly, the possibility of attaining an AIDS-free Zimbabwe, not only in terms of the AIDS pandemic, but also in terms of health from seemingly friends, we have no other intentions but to make Zimbabwe the colony. Well, those are topics of very great importance in the president of Zimbabwe. But fortunately or unfortunately, either his or my sole consensus for the day being is Zimbabwe at 60. Now, before I go on with my speech, I much love to say a happy birthday to my mother. I wish her to be there when Zimbabwe is 23 more years, she's going 37, as she also turns 60 along with me. I'm not going to lie to anyone by promising them a very close life by 2040. Neither am I going to make anyone believe that by then politics would have grown easier. In fact, it's going to take more credit to be at the top practice at this very moment. The very reason why we're making more mistakes than anticipated in Zimbabwe is not necessarily because we do not have money. I mean, really, we lost $15 billion, but we're still going on. Neither because we do not have millions of qualified personnel. Despite having so many jobs out there in Zimbabwe, you realize that our brothers, overqualified for that matter, can afford to finish tertiary education, come back home, roam around the streets. We have the brains. We can afford to have some food thrown onto the streets. It is not also because we don't have great politicians. I mean, really, we have great men and women at every level of government hierarchy representing us accordingly. Ladies and gentlemen, now that all we normally play is out of the picture, what? Anything else? 23 years from now, some will be doctors, some will be fathers, some will be engineers, some will be presidents, the like ones. And to balance nature, some of our own children will have to venture into Zimdanto, the China's jungles. But where we all have to grow up will be our education, our own economy, our commerce, our beloved Zimbabwean soil, in whose hands will all that be in? Don't dress as elegantly as our nowadays Pentecostal prophets. Unlike them, I'm not going to ask you to give me a million before I can give you the answer. Though such action is welcome. But the answer is in us. The answer is us. Ladies and gentlemen, 23 years is not such a long time. Comprising of only 5 DPS and the remaining 18 having one day missing age in the very Valentine month of February, it is one of the time that we just simply said, ladies and gentlemen, let us work towards creating a better Zimbabwe. For as long as we can remember, we've been taught on the benefits of unity. We've been given the evidence on what will come our way as long as we become one. Our own Joshua Ngong has always been saying, till his death, unity is the way forward. Ladies and gentlemen, let us be united, for it is through unity that development comes. Now, let's come together, let's bring our heads together, hand in hand, let us move one step at a time, together we can. Many political and economic analysts believe that Zimbabwe can be made a better place, of which so do I. But how good is a three-man relay team? We all have a hand to put in. As young as we are, as old that as you are, ladies and gentlemen, we all have a part to play. Let's believe in it. Let us become one. Let us work towards creating a better Zimbabwe. The whole of Africa, through great icons like Robert W. Mugabe, is echoing off the integration of Africa. Ladies and gentlemen, Zimbabwe is part and parcel of Africa. But we cannot unite with other nations before we are united together as one, as Zimbabweans. Let us be one. Let us make Zimbabwe a better place first. Then we can make Africa and the world in turn. Let's all put a hand in so that we all have a Zimbabwe in which we have political stability, economic efficiency, and social efficiency. Ladies and gentlemen, some of you might be wondering, perhaps, what would have happened during the 2018 election before we even get to 2040? Well, Zimbabwe has always known what is good for it, and as a result, it has always voted wisely. And I believe Zimbabwe knows what is good for it, and as a result, again, in 2018, we will vote wisely.